So, as most of you know, there's been talk of a new Harry Potter game coming out ever since early last year and even into 2018. And if you're like me, then this is probably the most excited you've ever been about a video game, ever. And I don't mean that as in I've never been excited about a video game, because I've been excited about plenty of video games like Halo and Assassin's Creed and things like that, but this takes my childhood movies, the essence of those movies that I've seen thousands of times, and then bringing it into a video game style that's probably one of my favorite to date. So throughout this video, I'm just going to be talking about some of the questions that are probably most common and the current answers that we have to those questions. So as of now, we don't have any kind of release date, nor do we even have an official announcement of the game from Warner Brothers. But we have rumors that the game could be premiered at E3 this year, alongside with other games like Batman and the new Rocksteady game, but because of the current situation with the world, that was postponed to possibly being released during the summertime, meaning that it will be announced in the summertime and then given an official release date from there. Again, there's not really any concrete evidence to support any of these possibilities, but from the leaks, we are given three main possibilities for the Harry Potter game. One being Harry Potter Magic Awakened, two being Harry Potter Magic Forever, and three being Hogwarts: A Dark Legacy. In my opinion, the last is probably the most likely, just because the game doesn't seem to have any direct line with the original storyline of the movies. So there's not really a need for the game to have a character in the title who doesn't even have context to the storyline. Again, I'm going to be saying this a lot throughout the video, but remember, there is nothing official about the game, so this is all speculation. But from the few videos and tweets and other things, it's believed that it'll be a massive open world role-playing RPG that will give you the opportunity to fully explore Hogwarts, and honestly, that's enough for me in itself, because that would be amazing. But you'll also be able to explore the outside village of Hogsmeade, as well as other locations like the Ministry of Magic and Gringotts Bank. Supposedly, you'll be playing as a fifth year transfer who can be customized and given one of eight class types. For the main storyline, you'll be helping Professor Eleazar Fig, who I can only assume to be Miss Fig's ancestor in some way, because we do know that Miss Fig from the original Harry Potter movies is a squib. But anyways, to continue, you help her to uncover a historic power, and that's all we're really given so far on the story. I can only assume that with this being an open world RPG, it seems likely that there will be some sort of storyline variation depending on which class you choose and which house you're in and your overall decisions throughout the game. So we could very well be seeing some different endings depending on how you play the game. Okay, so a huge question I expect every single Potterhead to have in this moment, probably not in this moment, but you have to have thought of this at least some point, is will this game include Quidditch? And again, you know what I'm gonna say? It's not 100% proof or probability of being true, but from what we have heard, we can expect to see some Quidditch minigames or side quests in the future. And with this being the main question when it comes to minigames and side quests, we're not really sure if what all we can expect to see in other minigames, but I would hope that we could see some things like a possibility of Wizard's Chess or quick games of exploding snaps and just other things like that. From the leaks, you can see that Avalanche Software will be leading the creation of the AAA title. And for anyone who doesn't know what AAA means, or the AAA title means, it's basically referring to the fact that the game will be highly ambitious. It'll be given a large budget and promoted widely upon release. But getting back into the Avalanche software, some of the games that they have released are games like older Mortal Kombat games, older TAC games, a lot of Disney games, and the main one being Disney Infinity. So with this being their newest game coming out, it is going to be without a doubt their largest project. And with their past of games, it's uncertain exactly what we'll be getting from this game. But remember, it is overall a Warner Brothers game, and they have been putting out good games as of recently, so we can expect to get a good game out of this one as well. So the thing I'm most excited about with this game coming out is the fact that I might finally get the Wizarding World game that I've always wanted, because while I have played the older games and some of them were fun in their time, they just weren't ever what I really wanted. So it'll be very interesting to see what this game does for us. We typically tend to get new games, and when they're very ambitious and upcoming, we tend to overhype them. And I want to try to do my best not to overhype this game and give it too large of expectations, because I don't expect it to be the best game ever, but I do expect it to be a good game. And I know I'm saying I want to try not to be too ambitious when I literally said at the beginning of the video that I've never been this excited for a game ever. So take everything I've said with a grain of salt, and don't take anything I've said as facts, but just as a possibility of what we could possibly see in the future. As always, I'd love to see what anyone has to say in the comments below, and if we do see a title drop anytime soon, I'll be sure to make a video updating you all about that. And until then, I hope you guys have a fantastic day, and I'll see you later.